because it's not for us, mm-hmm. it's for always the listeners. Mm-hmm. So we enjoy it, mm-hmm. do it good so that the fans will also enjoy it. Mm-hmm. So on this song, I have Black Messiah. Mm-hmm. That's it right next to me, right here.
Okay, that's so, Black Messiah.
Yeah, that's Kilo Day. Yeah, for your judgment board.
Yeah, man. I remember the last time I met this beautiful lady, she said in Ghana, when you ask somebody, how are you doing? The person says, it's not easy.
I remember.
So I was just hoping that you wouldn't say it's not easy. I still remember, fresh. Yeah. It's good, man.
Actually, the song is a it's a collaboration. It's not a feature song.
Okay.
It's not like I'm featuring Black Messiah. It's a song that was done both, like we came together to do this Kilo Day.
Okay.
So it's Black Messiah and
Lingua,
not Black Messiah featuring Lingua Cat.
Okay.
This is and
Lingua Cat. Okay, now let's go back into history. Some background information about you. Information is that you've been writing songs for Kaki and some of the high grade Asasiasi people. How true is that? Tell us about that before we even go into listening to this one.
Yeah, it's always it's always good diving in the past and then making people know who you are.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Jam Master J introduced me to writing songs for Kaki, and then because she was coming out, so we did a couple of things together, which was good, like Too Much, DC Turn Up, Top Girl, and a couple of others. You know,
okay, really, so let's be specific. You wrote Too Much.
Yes.
You wrote DC Turn Up.
Yes.
And Top Gear.
Top Gear. And I have a hook in Tuffy Pantang. Robo Lobo has almost been tight. You know, okay? It's almost been tight.
Ah,
okay.
Yeah. So that was the work that was going on because it was a high grade family.
Mm.
And it's always been a high grade family as successful records. So it wasn't any bad taste. It was actually online. I've done a couple for some gospel artists, and then one girl called Jada Sparkles.
Mm-hmm.
She did Semi Wicked and Bad. Boss girl, Semi Machine Naya Yard. Boss, Semi Bad and the Rings. Make a tune. Boss in Your Face.
Awesome.
Yeah, I did all those.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like, yeah, Jam Master J actually gave me that line.
So are you still writing for Kaki?
No more.
Why? Is there any issue?
No, there's no issue. Actually, I'm focused on what Lingua Cat is supposed to do as an artist individually to also, you know, mob up my fans, because if I could do a hit song for a female artist by singing the same song and writing the same song, nothing different changes.
Mm-hmm.
It's the same melody, same stuff. They don't change anything. So why wouldn't I have to focus on my career as a music artist and then make sure I do the same?
Okay, now you were also in a group, you were called Zyronite.
Yeah.
With a big man himself. What happened? Because I remember you guys released some fantastic songs at that time. Oh, no, I have bought the folder in town, man.
We forgot it once our manager.
I'm holding it.
Once
nobody beats me about that at all. So seriously, what happened to big man? You're no more with him.
Yeah, seriously, Zyronite was under Flex Entertainment. I said, my MOU. So yeah,
you and Bandana.
Yeah, Bandana and Big Nap. Jaamba is still doing good. Single,
okay.
You know, he came out with Black Rasta. They won the industry awards with the Ebola song. So Jaamba has been doing quite good also in reggae. We've not actually broken up Zyronite. We're doing individual stuff now, so that when it gets bigger, we're able to niche the fans. Then we can come together and then still pursue what we're doing, because Zyronite was strictly reggae.
Mm.
It wasn't anything but strictly a reggae concept stuff that we're trying to put out. So we realized that we have to put in commercial bits, and then we have to go solo and then mop up the fans, because without the fan base, is nothing.
Okay, so Jaamba is still doing his own thing,
yeah.
And you are also here.
Yeah.
Now, I remember during the heydays of Dansuman carrying music on his shoulders. Now, Lingua Cat was one of the big names. You were around with Samini and co. Do you still occupy that space, or now you are missing in action?
In Dansuman, if you say in Dansuman, I still occupy the space. But when you go on the street of Dansuman, they'll refer me Coolio. They wouldn't say Lingua Cat.
I know.
Because that was school days, you know what I'm saying? So I had to do a rebrand.
Mm-hmm.
Of the Coolio, because Coolio was a rap artist in the States,
yeah.
Which wasn't going well for me, so I had to just swap that name. And I remember in school my peers used to call me Lingua. So Lingua, wow, Lingua, okay, K-A-T, actually Lingua is Lingua Cat, and
mm-hmm.
The K-A-T stands for King of All Time, because
so,
I've been
so it
draining.
Is not the Aigwe Cat song?
Not the Jamwa, but it's still a Jamwa. It's a King of Cats, you know, lion type, but it's Lingua Cat, that means Lingua King of All Times.
Lingua King of All Times.
Yeah.
Oh,
so K-A-T, patched with Lingua, became Lingua Cat. and that was strictly under Asasiasi Records, because that was my first mother recording label that I've ever done anything with.
Okay.
They actually held me with my first recordings as a professional artist. So I've been with Asasiasi for the past 15 years. God knows why.
What kind of music do you do? Because sometimes you are doing reggae, sometimes you are doing...
I'm doing music. I'm not trying to be a reggae artist, a dancehall artist, a hip-life artist. I'm music. Once I feel what I have to do, believe me, I record it. I won't say because I'm a reggae artist, I'm supposed to limit myself to reggae. Or because I can do a lot of dancehall, then I have to strictly do dancehall. I will do music. Kel is where the balance is. Once it's good music, it's for the crowd, it's for the people, it's for the fans. That's my aim. It's not
so,
about...
So what is Kilo Day?
Kilo Day is an Afro dancehall tune with Black Messiah. And actually, I'm not even doing the Afro. He's actually doing the Afro on this. And he's supposed to be a hardcore governor dancehall artist.
Okay, let me talk to Black Messiah. Black Messiah, how are you doing?
I'm good.
You also have a name in the dancehall reggae fraternity, but you always seem to be on the low. You are not rising to the top. Is there any problem with you?
There's no problem.
GH is not being fair.
No, GH is okay. But it's the education, okay? Mm-hmm. You guys are doing a great job trying to let the audience understand what music is. Because me, my background, where I'm coming from, we don't want to talk about it right now. It's too big.
Why? Let's talk about it.
Because I was one of the last boys Matutu grew up. Took to London to tour all over the place.
Black Messiah?
Yeah. I used to be the leader of Kitty Warriors band, Matutu and the Kitty Warriors. So we've been all over the world. And when I got back to Ghana, it was a bomb. There wasn't no music, absolutely no music. So I could tell you, we have works all over for 15 years that have not been exposed to Ghana. I have them right now in Matutu's bed. So big things will be coming up. Because we'll be talking to people to do something. So kudos to Rodney King for discovering me to say, hey, come on, stop the stress. Let's do something.
Okay.
I can continue.
So have you also been signed by Asasiasi Records
now?
Yes,
officially I've been signed by Rodney. Because, you know, like I would have signed to High Grade Records with Samini, but it didn't work out because...
Why? What happened? Tony did not want you.
No. Tony liked me, and Tony is my buddy.
So what happened?
Tony and Samini, but already, because I'm a loyal person, okay, already, Rodney King has already discovered me at the show, and I've never seen no producer like that in Ghana, going to show purposely because he wanted to discover some artists. I was amazed. So that's where my loyalty ends with it. So I was in bed with Samini and Tony, but always, Rodney is my loyalty, you know.
But you are known to be a reggae musician.
Yeah, because we started the reggae dancer, me, Commander Messiah, and Black Prophet. We started in Ghana here, before Reggie came with Hip Live and all that.
Do you think reggae music in Ghana has chalked some success so far?
Yeah, at the long run, it has not gained popularity, but it has brought us royalty in terms of Rocky Downey. So we can tell Hip Life audience that they should back up because the audience have been hypocrite towards us. They gave them all.
Hip Life audience should back up.
They should back up. Hip Life artists should back up their works.
Okay.
Because the audience have been hypocrite towards us. Not at the eras of Samini coming to make them know say dancer can do something also, and Shatawale, Stoneboy them coming up to bridge the gap. If not so, like the audience have been unfair to us. Okay, because me, I was a reggae dancer artist. We started it before Suicide discovered me and we went out. When we got back, more of the guys have changed into hip life. So I mean, even I was shocked to see him doing hip life make song. But he always made me know, say, hey, yo, I'm trying to get these guys' attention. And when it worked out, it will work for all of us. And it's true. So I mean, he did that. So I mean, Ronnie Coaches, these guys were the guys who put the fork for dancer in terms of trying to battle with hip life, making it come out. That time, I heard of people like Lingua Cat on the street that these are guys and they have some squad that they move with, that they really doing good, but the audience don't give them no nod.
You mean the time that Lingua was waving flag on the stage for
something? Yeah, by that time Lingua even has been grooming
artists. He was waving flag, waving, man.
Yeah, waving the flag because of love, and Samini respects that because he knew Lingua as also an artist, with him, versatile artist.
Yeah.
So we like to show that love to each other to keep the energy going. So it's good that today the audience at least have given us some hearing, and with you guys creating the platform all the time for all of us to say, okay, if it's hip life, it's dance, or let's hear them, let's see who is good. So the net to net is now working. So I will urge all the dancer artists also to do a good job, play real music, don't just say dancer, because in Jamaica even they talk to the guys to do real dancehall music.
So what do you expect from Asasiasi Records now that you've signed your signature on their sheet?
Well, Asasiasi, we're going to Grammys because we have the links and the works is in the pipeline. Serious.
Is it because you have a white lady following you guys? That's
no,
why you...
No.
It's not
easy. It's not
easy. No, because you have a Bruni, so your Bruni will take you to London, sell your songs there. Is that what you guys
have been promised? Yeah, but it's part of the business. It's part of the management.
Well,
without that, where are they going to be?
Yeah, it's a credit, okay? Yeah. It's a credit. And also...
It makes you guys feel good.
The reason why I wanted to work with Rodney, from what he tells me as a producer, is... I had a white producer from England called Maxwell. So he has worked in Ghana here for 70 years. GTV knows him, all the TV stations, radio stations know him. He worked for free. He does a great job. And this guy is one of these Grammy producers. Okay, and he toured with us. He was our manager in the UK. So we toured all over everywhere. So he has been monitoring our works, me and Rodney. So it has hit him back to revive back, say, hey, something must be done. And this is the guy who made we met people like Chris Blackwell, the big guys. We talked to Queen St. Jones even on phone.
Wow.
Yeah, monitoring us on BBC and all that. So I know we have the map, the roadmap. It's just me and Lingua have to do the good work.
Wow. So we should watch out for Asasiasi Records 2016.
Yeah, I met it.
Okay, now Rodney, let me say hi to you.
Yes,
I know Rodney has a bad story that I can ask him. How far have you sorted the situation now?
We give thanks still, you know. We're taking it easy and gradually, you know. It's just unfortunate we lose our lab, but we build it.
So around how much have you lost in that disaster?
Well, I can't quantify. That's something I really spent time to do over 15 years, and you know the investment in Asasiasi.
I've been in that studio several times.
Yeah. But God knows we're building an ultra modern, you know, thing. We've been raising funds, wife and the global harmony team, Noise Voice Entertainment from the States to UK. They've been raising funds. If you go on my Facebook.
To support the studio.
All around the world, it's been overwhelming, you know, especially the feedback coming from the UK, the support is mad. I know Ghanaians are going to support with time.
Yeah. In fact, during the Christmas, I saw the message in my Facebook inbox, and no, this shouldn't happen, to have your studio bent. This is a serious issue.
Yeah, but we are going to catapult from there to reach higher heights, because it happens to lot of bigger labs, you know, bigger studios in the world have all gone through this, and it's just unfortunate.
Did you have insurance for your studio?
Unfortunately, no. I tried working on it, but they needed some requirement like security and all that. Which the next one, we can't do without that. We are insuring everything.
I see.
So we lose everything actually.
Fire bed in the fireman. Wow, that is a wonderful experience there, but all is well. I believe all is well. Okay, so let's go straight to listen to the song. This is called Kilo Day. Now, Lengwakat, who produced this one?
Well, the production was done in three phases. We have Wednesday Music being the background, playing through the beat, and then we actually recorded it in Asasiasi Records, and we have a keyboardist. Ezekiel. So it was actually three producers that went through on this recording.
Okay, and what is Kilo Day?
What's up?
It's WhatsApp.
It's a Nigerian word.
Meaning what's up?
Oh, okay. So you meet somebody gets a kilo day.
Kilo day. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Waiting the hopping. Waiting the hopping.
Okay. Fire burn, fire man. Alright, so let's listen to this one. Kilo Day, Asasiasi Records. Watch out for them 2016. Though they've gone through some challenges, but they still believe that all is well and they will be getting up very, very soon. So this is on the judgment board. Feel free and be part of the judgment process. Meanwhile, my judges are also here. Sally the Bond Man, DJ Roy, Justice Otin, and Kwame Ajimambeko. We are ready to do justice to Lingua Cat and Black Messiah. Kilo Day or Morgue Live.
Kilo Day. Achi, Sasiasi. Hey, pretty girl say you murder, inna the dance them call you a conquer. Pretty girl say you badder, inna the dance them call you a mother. Pretty girl say you murder, inna the dance them call you a conquer. Pretty girl you a murder, inna the dance them call you a murder. Sure.
Song, for instance, when they say Omoge Oluwa Gbemi, Lingua Cat, what is that?
Black Messiah.
Should explain that.
Yeah, he should explain that.
Okay, Black Messiah, what is Oluwa Gbemi? What is that?
you know, Oluwa, the word is Oluwa, is a name of a person, okay, a girl, and her behavior kills me. So I say Oluwa bad baby. But in the you composition, not all words must be pronounced. So Oluwa baby.
But that one is
you also know it can also have a different meaning.
Oh yeah, just language is like that. Okay. I did a little bit of languages, so I know language like that.
Okay.
Tonations that sound or the connotations that you get in some language means something awful in somebody's language.
Okay.
So it's all about happiness.
Okay, so you mean if somebody judges this on, say, a music review board, say, Music Awards, and they think, oh, that word there is not good.
No, I'll report that person to the Ghana
Magistrate. For what? What
violating the Ghana language.
Black Mesa, you crazy man. All right, thank you so much. We have to listen to this again for final judgment on Kilo D, that is Big Black and Black Messiah. But then to all the beautiful ladies in town, we still want you to maintain that beauty. So you have to go to Jamila Beauty Center anytime and go get your Hollywood star herbal product from USA. Of course, the ambassador, Sally Pimperman, is still here looking fresh and beautiful. So you can also go there and get your own, and the Hollywood star herbal product will repair and give you the best skin and color with no side effects. Now you can also 0243526412. This is Kilo Day once again, coming from Asasiasi Records 2016. Of course, you have to get ready for more because they are ready to move the world with their kind of music. Black Messiah and Lingua Cat on this one. When we come back, judges will talk, and you should also get ready to do judgments. Kilo Day. Okay, so Black Messiah and of course Lingua Cut on this one, Kilo D Omoge live one here in the studios of 89.9. Okay, DJ Roy, let's do quick judgment on this one.
Dance beat. There's a dance song. But I wanted to say something about.
Don't say what I want to say. You are like that. Go away.
Were you sharing ideas?
I was telling
you.
Yeah,
but I was going somewhere else.
No.
I wasn't going your
keep
way.
Keep to your lane.
You don't have to share ideas.
Keep
as
to
panel
your
members.
Lane.
Okay.
You keep yours.
I was talking about him writing for.
Better.
What do you think I was going to talk about? No. The point is that I even respect him more, the fact that he wrote hits for other artists, but that he didn't tell the truth when he said he's now thinking of writing for himself. The deal didn't go well. That is the truth.
The deal didn't go well for Khaki.
For him as a songwriter.
With Khaki and Co.
Yes, writing for people. It's one of the areas where you can actually make a lot of money as an artist who haven't broken yet. So when people have written for years and are multi-millionaires and we haven't heard of them yet, meanwhile they're artists signed to labels, but they write for these major acts. You understand? What is he should do is, I think maybe we have to go and get these GAMRO forms and put here. And when artists come, we give them, so that next time, I don't want you to stop writing for people. Because it doesn't mean that the fact that you wrote for somebody, you can write it for yourself and become a hit. It doesn't follow like that. So that logic is wrong. Okay, so we should get these forms here. Because being a songwriter, writing for multiple hits, Akwaba is also complaining. The deals are bad because we don't have publishers in this country. So we should help in that area. You know, that is it. But as for the song, it's the same thing. And I'm wondering, it's very difficult for me. I can program this kind of beat, but the moment I get this beat run, then I think something should come on, something should be added to it. You know, staying like that for 3 minutes is wickedness for me. It's like, why you staying there? I can't move. Because they're playing on A, and A is on the white. So there's too many rooms to do too many things. And they just stay there like that all throughout. And that is, but it's for dance, so they can, and then it's a dance beat. And I like it, because what they are saying is very controversial. In intense. It's very controversial in terms. So it's exciting. When you think about it, if you are dirty mind, you can go a long way with it. But if you are holy like me,
holy wrong.
So it's a good beat, okay. And I like it. They could even have used. They should have used this. Don't broadcasting thing.
Okay.
Tone, you know.
Yeah.
It's like they are shouting for the girl. That kind of concept would have been exciting, but it's beautiful. It's okay.
All right.
Okay.
Sally from Poman, take over from the man DJ Roy. Let me listen to you on this one. Kilo D, Black Mesa, and Lingua Cat.
Uncle Roy, the seducer. That's your nickname, right? What I want to say is that, and even women are never not customer. At your Makuma,
so Papa. So I have a win. I have a chance. You can be nice to me.
Kumo,
you be nice
Sally,
to me.
Go ahead. I have an interview with Nila.
Okay. What it is that as I'm not kind about Lingua Cat, I think you should look into it again. You know, because now maybe it's not making you money, but you know, gradually we'll get there. A time, you know, when dancehall never put you before, but now the world is looking at you people. This is what I would say about you, the two of you as people. I have been educated here today on the fact that you see these guys on the street and you think that they are empty. Shatta Wale speaks, and I'm like, this guy is intelligent.